decision making, showing them the scoreboard, making them the owner. Have you ever faced any challenges sustaining their motivation in the long run? Because once the practice is established and there is no new change, people might get bored again.
Yeah. No, you're right, that happens. So, which is why you have an idea of making them into team leaders. So, you have to change their job roles. They will become supervisors or assistant managers or managers. A lot of our internal recruitment process also has promotions from within the team. But having said that, if you have 640 people, you cannot make 640 managers. So one of the things that we are doing, and you can be innovative for it. So let's, and this is a real example now. So we have a welding operator. Two of his colleagues who were with him for the last 10, 12 years have become supervisors. This guy unfortunately lacks supervision capability completely. None of his bosses feel that he can be made a supervisor. Unfortunately for him, we also don't need a third supervisor. So now he's stuck in a rut. You know, exactly the case you said, how do you motivate a person like this? So here was our answer to him. What we are doing is we have created a small studio within our campus, which is basically fitted with a video camera, an audio device, a recording device. Every single employee is motivated to become a trainer. So I called this welding guy and I said, look, it might seem the end of the road for you because we don't need a supervisor. People feel you can't be made into a supervisor, but you are a good worker. So we don't want to lose a good worker. If you get demotivated, we probably lose you as a worker. That's not something we want. Right? If you still get demotivated and continue to work here, we will have a bad worker, which is also not acceptable. From a good appraisal, you start getting bad appraisals. Your productivity will go down. None of that is acceptable to either you or to us. So what can we do about this? Use your talent to spread the good word. So what does he do? He comes into that video room now with five capacitors. Three of them are welded correctly and two of them are welded badly. And he starts now giving a little lecture, literally to a blank screen, saying, कैसे पता लगता है कि ये कैपेसिटर अच्छा वेल्डिंग है या ये खराब वेल्डिंग है? देखने से भी पता लग सकता है कि इसका वेल्डिंग ठीक है या नहीं. Now with 10 years of experience, this is a really no stuff that we don't want to lose him because of that reason. This is an 8-minute training session, out of which he spent 6 minutes on telling them purpose. Last 2 minutes he says, अब आप मुझे बताइए ये पांच में से कौन सा कैपेसिटर खराब है और कौन सा अच्छा है. It's like a test. That's where the video stops. He will come back for another video session and now say, एक अच्छे वेल्डिंग कैपेसिटर कैसा दिखता है, तुम्हारे पिछले आपको सेशन में बताया था. अब ये जब आप नेक्स्ट स्टेशन पे जाएगा तो ये उस प्रोसेस को कैसे फायदा करेगा और अगर खराब हवा वहां पहुंच जाएगा तो उस स्टेशन पे क्या गड़बड़ होगी. थर्ड डे ही कम्स इन एन एडवांस लेक्चर नाउ एंड सेज, मशीन की सेटिंग क्या होनी चाहिए ताकि वेल्डिंग सही हो, किस गलत सेटिंग की वजह से गलत कैपेसिटर बनेगा. थर्ड सेशन, सही सेटिंग कैसे करनी चाहिए. फोर्थ सेशन, सही मशीन को कैसे आप रिपेयर और मेंटेन कर सकते हैं ताकि वो हमेशा सही सेटिंग करे. फिफ्थ सेशन. सो दिस गाय इज नाउ एन ऑथर ऑफ 20 सच सेशंस. व्हेन अ पर्सन इज रिक्रूटेड इन द कंपनी, वी आर ट्राइंग टू नाउ दैट प्लेटफॉर्म इज बीइंग बिल्ड. वी विल बिल्ड अ ट्रेनिंग प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर एवरी एम्प्लॉई हु वर्क्स इन विल गेट अ सेट ऑफ 50-60 सच YouTube वीडियोस दैट ही हैज टू गो थ्रू. Some of them will be essential, which if he's a welding operator, then he better know this. If he is an operator on the next stage, he should know this. If he is an operator on the earlier stage, he should know this. But some first aid, fire prevention, emergency healthcare, they might be desirable, right? And some of them for some people will be necessary. So we will give them these three, and as we call it, essential, necessary and desirable training programs that they have to watch, and give that little 1 minute test at the end and upload that answer onto our system. So our HR of those three people will become one of the best training teams, I hope, very soon because of this. And you can collaborate with this. So many of these videos are for public consumption. There's no confidentiality in how we deal with a fire. Everybody deals with a fire in the same way. So those you put in the public domain, and any other factory wants to use it, company wants to use it, institution wants to use it, more than happy. So this welding operator, Tejaram, now becomes a famous welding operator because at least in some videos, the other 600 people definitely know him, and maybe more than 600 people know him depending on what he wants to do. So these are some of the innovative ways that you can do it, and as I'm sure that fresh young brains like you will find even better answers. The task this morning that I took upon myself is to leave that seed, that way of thinking, so that then the innovation and all that can grow out of that. You know, nobody short of how to do something, why to do it is the most important part. What kind of an HR manager you want to be, I hope this will have some difference. Yes sir, any other questions? Yes, you asked that question. Sorry, I didn't answer it fully. I think diversity is something that we should celebrate. So what we do is, of course, in the HR, we try to make a big effort in making sure that there are enough women, there are enough Muslims, there are enough Sikhs. They're at least well represented. Yeah, I'm coming to that. So what we also do is celebrate the festivals together wherever possible. When we have our annual cultural festival, we try to bring dance and music from different places, done by our own employees. Now coming to the work part of it, quite frankly, I feel that a lot of this diversity actually, there is only one reason where we can go wrong, is where we have a lack of respect for the others. So we begin to think that because I'm a mechanical engineer, I know more than the chemical engineer, which is actually, if you see in the context of something, it's quite a stupid thought. But unfortunately, this is exactly how teams begin to work. So what we also do is we have something called an open project, which means that any employee in the company can bid for a project. And he can say, look, I want to, I don't know, compress the energy in the compressor by 10%. So he does the research, because that may be his domain knowledge. He has some bright idea. And he puts that, he comes to us as management and says, this is something I want to do. If we like the idea and we see that it is feasible, we normally try to encourage them, we say, okay. That is when we call it a target resource review. So what is the target of the project and what are the resources you require? And in the resources, this guy can say, I want the MD of the company to be my member of this team. So my question to, I have no authority to say I will not be a member of this team. Anybody who invites me to a team, I will be there. But I have to work then as a team member and not as the MD of the company, or not as the CEO. But my question to him is, what is that skill that you want me to use? And he's very open and he says, you know, the managing director of the pneumatics company, I want a lot of help from the pneumatics company. So your job in my team is only to coordinate, to make sure that I get that help from the other team. So you empower the guy at a junior engineer level, he can have the CEO of the company working as a team member. I will report to him at the time he wants. He will allocate hours for me and I'll have work. I have no problem. So we have forced, to some extent, I wouldn't say diversity really, but different people. So you can ask a chemical engineer to come and say, okay, you are the big shot who keeps telling me all the time that you know much more than me. Please come and help me now in this project. I need this kind of a silicon mining. Can you help me with that silicon mining? And so we are encouraging that kind of a thing from happening. Having said that, I think we are going to have now a very interesting challenge, because we have a division called Sure Solutions that does electronics for retails. So if you walk into a Bata anywhere in the country, for example, the office is right here, all their Bata stores, everybody who walks in is counted by a thermal counter. So you're not, your image is not taken, but your heat image is taken. So we know when you are coming in, at what time are you going out, how many people come and go out, how many people are in the store at any time. How many of those people, of course, in Bata there's no trial room, but in many other stores where there is a trial room. So we give the customer on his phone, he can get analysis of what are his peak hours, lean hours. We can predict what will happen on next Sunday, what will happen on next Diwali, what kind of staffing he should do based on the last three Diwalis. So all this being done through a very automated system. Now, this is one, but we also do anti-shoplifting equipment. We do a lot of things for retail, electronic shelf labels, etc., etc. Now, this team that goes and deals with the retail is a very different team. They have been paid very differently. In fact, they are largely salespeople and they've got to be given a commission. In capacitors, we don't give any commissions. So now there is a clash of ideals saying why that team gets commissions, why this team doesn't get commissions. Why some of them at much younger age are getting a higher salary than we are getting in this team. Why these are the 640 people who created that other team. So yes, there is a current challenge that we are facing. And the way I'm trying to deal with it is, that these 640 people are actually incubators at DEKI. So if they begin to get this feeling that you are the fathers, you are the parents of that team, how happy would you be if that team begins to earn more money than you? How, and in fact it happened last month, that team, the profitability of that team was 50% of the profitability of the whole company, 50% of the other team. Happened in 3 years' time, I mean of course 8 years they've been around, but this is a bunch of 18 people compared to a team of 640 people, and they managed to do that. Of course it happened only 1 month, may not happen all the time. But that ownership could also happen. Again, the same principles will be applied. So not to say that our people in our team don't have the same anxieties and the same issues, the same diversity problems that anybody else has. But the way of dealing with it, hopefully, is good. So, the gentleman there is very sleepy. Yeah? Had a late, tough night?